Nadia from Body and Burden, and today I just wanted to show you some of my favorite all-natural, non-toxic sunscreens because I think that this is just one of the most difficult products to find. That award definitely used to go to mascara. It was super hard to find a natural mascara. Now I feel like there's a million awesome natural mascaras that really perform, but sunscreen is still just incredibly hard to find one that's really safe and also doesn't leave you looking white like a ghost. So first of all, when it comes to natural sunscreen, there's just a few things that I personally look for. The first one is zinc oxide as the main active ingredient. So zinc oxide provides really great protection from both UVA and UVB rays. And then I look for it in its non-nano form. So because zinc oxide can leave skin looking so white, a lot of times companies will use a form of zinc oxide that has basically undergone this process that makes the particles super tiny. So they're micronized. I don't even know if I'm pronouncing that correctly, but basically they're these microscopic little versions of the zinc oxide particles. And so there's not a ton of evidence that suggests that this is something to be concerned about, but the concern is that it can enter your bloodstream and then we don't really know what they're doing in there. And so it's sort of that precautionary principle. And because sunscreen is something that you're applying all over, you know, to the majority of your skin, all over your body, you're applying it to your kids, I personally do follow that precautionary principle and so choose the non-nano version of zinc oxide. And then of course we want to be avoiding other unhealthy ingredients like parabens, artificial fragrance, of course the list goes on and on and on, but these options today that I'm going to be showing you are really super clean. They all have a 1 rating in the Environmental Working Group Skin Deep database, which levels, you know, the toxicity of personal care products, 0 being like water, totally safe, although we all know that water isn't necessarily totally safe anyways, and 10 being like toxic sludge that you of course don't want anywhere near your body. So yeah, I'm excited to show you these options. To me, so this is a very short list. These are really the best of the best, like the best that I have been able to find. And so that's why I'm excited to show them to you. And of course, I felt the need to make a video because I could tell you how awesome they are, but I'm sure that we have all bought a non-toxic natural sunscreen before. And then, you know, the ingredients look great, it's recommended to us, but we apply it to our skin and it's just like trying to wipe putty into your skin and you look like a ghost and it just, it's no good. So I'm really excited about these options. They truly are the best that I found over the years. Again, it's a really short list because I'm sure there's other great options out there, but I just simply haven't found them. So let's go over each of them and I'll just explain what makes them, you know, unique, and then I'll show you how they're actually performing on the skin as well. Okay, so first we have Beauty Counter's Counter Sun Collection, and this is so new. Like, this came out within the past couple of weeks, and I was so excited when I got it and tried it, and it actually worked, because again, that's always a fear, like, a new product comes out and you hear all these amazing things and the ingredients look great, but then it just doesn't perform. And that could not be further from the truth with these products. They perform amazingly well. So they're made with non-nano zinc oxide, but then miraculously, somehow, they totally blend into the skin to be totally invisible. I just love them. And the benefit of these is that they also have a really great dose of antioxidants, which is of course providing your skin with, you know, the power to fight those free radicals, which UV rays do incite in your skin. So it's sort of giving your skin an extra line of defense. So this is actually a mist, but it's a non-aerosol. They use a non-aerosol can. So it's actually an air mechanism. So there's no unhealthy chemicals that you have to worry about inhaling or worry about going into the environment or going on your skin. So they really thought this through very smartly. They're considering all aspects, and you'll see it's like, it's totally gone. So it sprays on white, which is awesome because you can make sure you're not missing everything, especially important if you have kids. You don't want to, you know, be missing any little streaks while their little bodies are trying to, you know, run towards the beach and away from you trying to put sunscreen on them. But then it really easily rubs in super clear. It leaves your skin like really dewy and moisturized feeling to the touch, but not by any means sticky. I wouldn't think that like sand would stick to it, anything like that. Just, you know, again, I love it. I couldn't love it more. And then there's a lotion option. So it's really sort of, honestly, I would say the same product, right? It's just giving it to you in a mist versus a lotion. And so again, let's take a look. I put a little too much, which is my own fault. So I'm gonna have to, it's okay. I'll be nice and protected when I go out in the sun later. Okay. So again, rubs in super easily, leaves your skin feeling nice and dewy and moisturized, but without feeling sticky or like you've just applied a ton of product to it. And then they also have this really convenient little stick. So I do like these little sticks for keeping in my purse or my car. And again, you'll see when you rub this on, again, non-nano zinc oxide, but it's completely completely clear. So again, this is the Counter Sun collection. Oops. And you probably know that I love Beauty Counter because it really is just like a company on a mission, a company with a conscience. They're really trying to change the totally broken, you know, beauty and cosmetics industry from the inside out. They do a lot of lobbying to Congress. It's a company I'm really proud of, you know, being affiliated with. And most importantly, their products just really perform. And so these definitely held up to those standards of being super safe and also performing like a dream. Okay, and then my other favorite is this Think Baby SPF 50+. They say anything over SPF 30, sort of all the same, but we know you're getting great coverage. Again, uses the non-nano zinc oxide to give you that UVA and UVB protection. Has a really short, really clean ingredient list. Again, has the one environmental working group Skin Deep database rating. It's just overall a really fantastic product. And like the Counter Sun, you know, uses the non-nano zinc oxide, but again, rubs in completely clear. So I will tell you, I think the biggest differences between this and the Beauty Counter Sun collection is that, first of all, this doesn't really have any of the bells and whistles in terms of those antioxidants, sort of more utilitarian, but it does its job and it does its job well in terms of, you know, providing great protection and rubbing in really clear. As you can see, you can't see it at all. The other thing is that this does tend to sit on the skin a little bit more, whereas the Beauty Counter really sinks in. So this doesn't bother me so much, but my husband is a big sweaty guy who he complains about this. So he says that it gets like a little gooey once he starts to sweat, and he's just like always sweating. But whereas the Beauty Counter really sinks into his skin. So for that reason, he's a big Beauty Counter fan. But it's a really budget-friendly option. Again, it does the job, and it does the job well. Even though it does sort of get that gooey feeling once you do start to sweat, it is water-resistant up to 80 minutes, it says. So yeah, another really fantastic, great option. So with these two, you definitely have some good options here. I mean, I know that this list is short again, but what more could you need? So you can really go have some fun in the sun without having to worry about looking like a ghost or trying to feel like you're rubbing putty into your skin, which is never fun, and you can miss spots. So yeah, here you go.